Hi, I'm Brian Gaines, a developer in the Analytics Division of R&D at SAS. Specifically, I develop user interfaces in SAS Studio called Tasks, which enable you to prepare and analyze your data without writing any SAS code. Instead, as you navigate a task menus and options, the underlying code is automatically generated for you in real time. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a new task in SAS Studio to jumpstart the development of SAS code to train an image classification model with the power of SAS VIA. Computer vision attempts to mimic the human brain's ability to process images. One such technique is image classification, in which the goal is to classify entire images into one of multiple predefined categories. You could build an image classifier to catalog different products, tag user-generated images, or visually inspect utility lines, to name just a few applications. Because of their ability to achieve human-like performance, convolutional neural networks, or CNNs, have become the workhorse models for solving difficult computer vision problems. CNNs are a type of artificial neural network, which means their fundamental structure is the same. However, CNNs use convolutional and pooling layers to exploit the fact that the inputs are images, thus improving efficiency and performance. As an image progresses through the network, the initial convolutional layers extract basic visual patterns or features from the image, such as edges and curves. These patterns are combined in the downstream layers to represent more complex patterns that the model uses to ultimately generate the predicted class probabilities for the output. As an example, suppose you are interested in building a CNN to classify images as containing either dolphins or giraffes. To do this, we have a total of 94 images of dolphins and giraffes. To reproduce this example, you can access this dataset in code by visiting the SAS Global Forum 2020 GitHub repository. The first thing you need to do is load your images into a data table in SAS. Then you often want to display the images. This is where the new load images task in SAS Studio is very helpful. So let's open SAS Studio to see this task in action. After opening SAS Studio, you click the task icon on the left to access the task, and then expand the SAS task folder to display the task we've developed at SAS. For this example, the task you want is located in the SAS VIA machine learning category, and then in the computer vision subfolder. So let's expand those and then double click to open the load images task. This task, as well as the other VIA task, requires a connection to a SAS Cloud Analytics Services server, which I have already made. When you open a task, on the left you have the settings and options for the task, and at the bottom is a task console that lists the items you must address before you can run the task. On the right you have the work area, which initially consists of comments in the code because so far the minimum requirements for the task have not been met. The first thing you need to specify is the parent directory that contains your images, so let's select the Giraffe Dolphin Small folder and click OK. The other requirement is to name the output table that will contain the images. So let's create the table in the cast user cast lib and name it images. After making that selection, you can see that with just a few clicks and keystrokes, the task generates over 50 lines of code to load and display the images. The task does include additional options that govern how the images are loaded and displayed, but let's stick with the default values and click run to run the task. In addition to loading your images into a table in SAS, the results also display a subset of your images with the automatically created class label and a unique ID above each thumbnail. Now that your images are in a data table in SAS, you can continue with the rest of your analysis by using code snippets and examples from sources such as SAS documentation, GitHub, and blog posts. For example, let's run this code block to explore your images by looking at summary information and label frequencies. Consistent with what I said earlier, the data table contains 94 images, and for the class distribution, you see that there are slightly more dolphins than giraffes. Next, let's perform some common pre-processing steps for the images. First, you want to resize your images to match the image size that is required for one of the models we want to use.
After resizing, you then randomly shuffle the images. Initially, the dolphin and giraffe images are grouped together in the image table.
This can cause problems when you are training your model because it biases the parameters to overpredict a certain class. Shuffling alleviates this issue. Finally, you want to randomly partition your images into training and validation sets. Another common pre-processing step for images is data augmentation. You can augment the data in a number of different ways, such as cropping, rotating, or flipping your original images. This creates synthetic images to enlarge your training data, which is especially helpful when your training data set is small, as in our case. This code creates cropped versions of your images and then resizes them to match the rest of the images. Let's run this code. You can see in the augmented data set that we now have 104 images of dolphins and 84 of giraffes. After you explore and prepare your data set, you can build and train CNNs to classify the images you are interested in. The next part of this code, which again is available on GitHub, includes an example of building a simple CNN model from scratch so you can see those mechanics in case it is of interest and relevant for your use case. This enables you to slowly and flexibly build the model architecture layer by layer. For each layer, you identify the model to add the layer to, in addition to specifying the name and type of the layer. You can also specify the hyperparameters specific to the layer type, such as the activation function and number of filters for a convolutional layer. After you build the model architecture, you use your augmented training data set to train your model. You then use the trained model to score your other images, and you can use a confusion matrix to assess the model's performance. In the interest of time, I'm going to jump ahead to the results I obtained when I ran this code earlier. In the results, you can see that this simple CNN model performs fairly well with a misclassification rate of only 6% on the validation set. However, in general, building a model from scratch is very challenging because defining the model architecture and estimating the model requires you to specify many different hyperparameters. Also, training the model often takes a lot of time, computational resources, and training data for it to perform very well. Instead of reinventing the wheel, an easier and more practical approach is to take a well-performing model that someone else already trained and apply it to your problem. This is known as transfer learning. To do this, let's use a popular CNN model known as ResNet 50, which has been shown to perform very well in image classification, and let's use your image dataset to fine-tune the model for your application. In terms of the code, just like before, you first need to define the model architecture, which is done using an external .sas file because it takes about 700 lines of code to define the architecture for such a deep network. The SAS code to build a few of the popular deep learning models is available on our website. Next, after you download the pre-trained weights from our website, you import and associate them with your model. To set up this model, another thing to keep in mind is that ResNet 50 was originally trained on the famous ImageNet dataset, which contains 1,000 different classes. However, in our application, there are only 2 classes, so you need to remove the original output layer and replace it with an output layer that contains only 2 units. Now that everything is set up, you can use your dataset to fine-tune ResNet 50 to your application and then score the validation data. This training code is essentially the same as before, except now you include an option to initialize the model weights by using the pre-trained weights so that you can fine-tune those weights with your data. As before, in the interest of time, let's skip ahead to the results. Keeping in mind that the validation set is not very large, the ResNet 50 model is able to perfectly classify every image in the validation set, so it outperformed our simple CNN model. The final step is to save the information for this champion model as an analytic store. You can use this portable model format to easily deploy and manage the model by using SAS Model Manager software, or to make real-time decisions by using SAS Event Stream Processing software. As you can see, the new Load Images task jumpstarts the development of SAS code for training a deep learning image classification model. For more information, please visit the SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning product page and the SAS Studio Task Reference Guide. Thanks for watching.